morning, church. Wishing each and everyone a happy Resurrection Day. Jesus is alive. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus is alive.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm reading John chapter 11, 25 and 26. Let's hear what the Word of God says. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this? Yes, we all do.
Yes. I'm going to read from Mark chapter 16, verses 1 to 6. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb. And they asked each other, who will roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb? But when they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe, sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. Don't be alarmed, he said. You are looking for Jesus the Nazarene who was crucified. He has risen. He is not here. Amen. He has risen and he is not here.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to sing our first song and please join us. It's My Redeemer Lives. He's not dead. He's alive. Amen.
My face and love, my
Jesus. He is the King of glory. Who is the King of glory? The Lord God Almighty. Amen. Amen. He is the King of glory. We're going to sing our next song, King of Glory.
Shame in love you came. Cristo
excited today? Do you know what is being celebrated throughout the globe today? Resurrection Sunday. Hallelujah. Though we are unable to assemble together in one place, you can celebrate this joyful day along with us in your homes. I'm sure you know that Jesus died on your behalf and my behalf, taking the punishment and penalty of death for our sins. For the wages of sin is death. Romans 6:23 tells us. He was buried. On the third day, he rose again. 2 Corinthians 15:4 tells us. And he is alive. Jesus is alive. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We have a living Christ amidst us. We have a risen Christ living in us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What do you think was the reason for the sinless Christ to take that ultimate step to die for us sinners or to die on our behalf? Nothing. Only pure, holy love. Romans 5:8 tells us, God demonstrated his love for us in that while we were yet still sinners, Christ died for us. I'm sure you will agree with me that we, the least deserving, are bestowed with the greatest demonstration of love by Jesus. All for the pure joy. Who for the joy that was set before him, that is Jesus, endured the cross, despising the shame. Hebrews 12:2 tells us. Today, as you celebrate the resurrection day along with us, let that unspeakable joy, full of glory, explode from within to without. God wants you to be a joyful Christian. With this revelation and understanding of his purpose and of the death and resurrection of his son Jesus Christ. And what is that? God wants you to embrace the whole Christ, not just one facet of his life, but to embrace him in his totality. And that is the suffering Christ, the risen Christ, the reigning Christ, and finally, the soon coming Christ. Who says to you, as you get the understanding of this truth at every step of this revelation, I have come that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be full. John 15:11. Let the resurrection power of Christ be explosive in your life from today onwards. As the word of God in Romans 8:11 tells us. But if the spirit of him, that is God, that raised up Jesus from the dead, dwells in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwells in you. I want to encourage each and every one of you. This is the hope of resurrection, for the joy that is set before us in the resurrection. We can endure the cost of love. We can endure the cost of persecution, no matter how grave the cost to pay. Beloved, your suffering is coming, believe me. All who desire to live godly in Christ Jesus will suffer persecution. 2 Timothy 3:12 tells us. How will you endure it? The answer is the joy that is set before you. Only when you understand it by revelation will you draw on the explosive power of resurrection within you. By simply rejoicing that your redemption is drawing near. Luke 21:28. By simply rejoicing that all men may know your endurance, your forbearance. Philippians 4, verse 4 and 5. By simply rejoicing and being glad, knowing the reward is great in heaven. Matthew 5:12. By simply rejoicing that this light, momentary affliction is preparing you for eternal weight of glory. 2 Corinthians 4:17. So, beloved, sing to the Lord and love the persecutors. For blessed are you when they revile and persecute you. Refrain from grumbling, complaining, and hating those persecuting you. Draw from the resurrected Christ who lives in you and his sustaining resurrection power. And finally, I say to you, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now we are moving to a solemn moment, and that is breaking of the bread and drinking of the cup, for it is the cup of the new covenant in the blood of Jesus. I'm reading from 1 Corinthians 11, verses 23 to 32. You may follow it up in your Bibles at home. For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Therefore, whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of sinning against the body and blood of the Lord. A man ought to examine himself before he eats of the bread and drinks of the cup. For anyone who eats and drinks without recognizing the body of the Lord eats and drinks judgment on himself. That is why many among you are weak and sick, and a number of you have fallen asleep. But if we judge ourselves, we would not come under judgment. When we are judged by the Lord, we are being disciplined so that we will not be condemned with the world." If you notice, in 1 Corinthians 11, verses 24 and 25, commands us, do this in remembrance of me. So let's bring to our minds the divine exchange that took place on the cross of Calvary. Jesus was punished that we might be forgiven. Jesus was wounded that we might be healed. Jesus was made sin with our sinfulness that we might be made righteous with his righteousness. Jesus died our death that we might live his life. Jesus became a curse that we might receive the blessing of Abraham. Jesus became poor that we might become rich. Jesus bore our shame that we might share his glory. Jesus endured our rejection that we might have His acceptance with our Father. Jesus was cut off that we might be joined to the Lord. In Jesus, our old man was put to death, that in Him the new man might come to life in us. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Now take time to thank the Lord with gratefulness for all the benefits and blessings you have received. For Psalm 103 tells us, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits." So begin thanking the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for your blessings, your benefits. Oh, we are eternally grateful.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Lord Jesus, we thank you that your body was broken on the cross to give us wholesomeness and contentment. We thank you, Jesus, for shedding your precious blood on the cross of Calvary. By the shedding of your precious blood, we have cleansing of every of our unrighteousness and healing of our bodies.
Hello, church. This is Prophet Tony, Senior Pastor of Kingdom Seekers International Church, Mumbai, India. I'm going to speak to you today, which is Resurrection Sunday, April 12, 2020, on the topic Resurrection Power. Hallelujah! Jesus is alive. Death has lost its victory and the grave has been denied. Jesus lives forever. He is alive. He is alive. Jesus is alive. He is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and last Z. The curse of sin is broken and we have perfect liberty. The Lamb of God has risen. He's alive. He's alive. Jesus is alive. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shall we give a praise offering unto the Lord? Just for about a minute or so. Come on. Congregation, wherever you are, in the house, let's start blessing the Lord. Hallelujah. Almighty God, we give you praise. We give you thanks. There is none like you, Lord. There is no God like you, God. We want to thank you that you have risen, Lord. You have broken the power of sins, Lord. You washed away our sins by your precious blood. You are alive and you are so grateful, Lord. And we know you are coming. One of these days you are coming back again. Lord, we want to worship you. We want to bless you, Lord. El Elyon, El Tisipoy, El Shaddai. The glorious God and the great I am. You are worthy of honor. You are worthy of praise. Hallelujah. Can you say three times with me? Hallelujah. 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 He's the one who died to cleanse us and clear our record of all sin. I'm sure you know that. And then he sat down in the place of the highest honor given to him by the side of the great God of heaven, our Heavenly Father. Now someone said, Christianity is based on the law of forgiveness and an empty tomb. How true it is. Calvary expresses the love of God. Resurrection explains the power of God. Hallelujah. You know, resurrection is the greatest event that draws the line between Christianity and all other religions on planet Earth. Jesus rose from the dead. His tomb is empty, and that is proof. Hallelujah. Now, Christianity is our great confession. Wherefore, brethren, partakers of the heavenly calling, consider Jesus Christ, the apostle and the high priest of our confession. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace to receive his mercy and find grace to help in time of need. We see that in Hebrews 3:1 and Hebrews 4:16. That I may know him and the power of his resurrection. Apostle Paul writes this in Philippians 3:10. Now there are four important interconnects that believers should take special note of. Calvary, resurrection, resurrection power, and return. Hallelujah. Now let's go to Calvary, our first point. The most completed historical event depicting the death of Jesus on Calvary's cross. God left nothing undone. In fact, Jesus says it is finished. God left nothing undone at Calvary by the substitutionary death of his beloved son, Jesus. You know what? Wonderful things have happened at Calvary. The curse was broken, Galatians 3:13. Sins were washed away by his precious blood, 1 John 1, verse 7. The power of sin is broken, Romans 6:10. Sickness was borne by Jesus. Poverty was annulled, 2 Corinthians 8:9. An abundant life was given, John 10:10. Now we go to our next point, resurrection. Jesus rose from the dead on the third day. He defeated Satan, hell, and the grave. And the empty tomb proves it. Jesus lives forever. 2 Corinthians 5:15. No other religion has a resurrection. Next point, return. The disciples gazed at the ascension of Jesus while he promised them he's going to return. The angel assured them that he would come back again. Acts 1:1. Now Jesus has assured us he's coming back again. He's coming to take us to our heavenly home. The prophets and the sons of prophets in these days are busy heralding the return of our Lord Jesus Christ. Next, resurrection power or the power of resurrection. Now, what are we to do at a time between resurrection and return? Simply, we are to know Jesus and we are to show Jesus to the world. How? By the power of resurrection that indwells us, or the Holy Ghost power. The same Holy Ghost who brought Jesus and put him into the womb of Mary, his mother, is the same Holy Ghost who raised Jesus from the dead. The same Holy Ghost who is living on the inside of us. For he is able to do exceeding abundantly above all we ask or dare think of, according to his power at work in us. Ephesians 3 verse 20. We are to call those things that are not just as though they already were. Romans 4 and verse 17. We have the resurrection power. Say with me, I have the resurrection power to cancel and expel this virus and its effects globally from planet Earth and much more. We have the resurrection power of the Holy Ghost on the inside of us. I want to read to you Romans 8:19. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the sons of God. How? Through the power of the Holy Ghost, through the power of praise and worship and intercession and groaning and decree. And this virus shall cease to exist and it's high time. Now I want to tell you something that is worth remembering, and it is about Prophet Elisha, the great miracle worker of 2 Kings. When he was alive, he did wonderful miracles. Even after he died, the power was still there. It was unfading power that a dead man rose up from the dead. Elisha was in constant touch with God. That is why he was able to bring life out of dead situations. Wherever he went, it was the same thing with Apostle Paul. And people came from all over to receive his help with problems and needs. What about you? What about the resurrection power in you? Do you sense it? Do you feel it? Are you in constant touch with Almighty God? Are you in touch with His Holy Word? Only then can you expect to allow Him to use you increasingly and effectively. And you know, beloved, we can do nothing without the Holy Ghost power. For did he not say in Acts chapter 1 and verse 8, but you shall receive power when the Holy Ghost shall come upon you, and you shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, to the uttermost parts of the earth? I tell you, the time of the Lone Rangers is over. Do not resurrect them. Do not hero worship them. Although you need to honor and esteem them because they have labored in God's kingdom, and you need to practice the godly principles that you have learned from them. But don't go back. Go forward. Your time has come into your excellent prophetic future. I read from Revelation 22:9. He said, no, don't worship me. I am a servant of God, just like you and your brothers, the prophets, as well as all who obey what is written in this book. Worship only God. The God of them now expects you and me to move with power because you got the Holy Ghost on the inside of you. He is the greater one, and you've got the scriptures beside you on the side of you, and you have God generals behind you to be able to back you up. For God does everything beautiful in His time. Ecclesiastes 3. I read Habakkuk 2:14. For the earth shall be filled with the glory of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. It's a new day. It's a new hour. It's a new visitation in a brand new way. Revealing the Father, exalting the Son, God's Holy Spirit is making us one. I want to read to you what Rick Joyner says. The kingdom of God is coming, and it cannot be stopped or slow down, but it can be hastened. We are told that we should be looking for and hastening the coming of the day of the Lord. 2 Peter 3:12. Now, what could we do to help bring His kingdom faster? We can do this by building our lives on His kingdom now and preaching the good news of His kingdom everywhere we go. Are you ready for a revelation now? This is what I believe. And I've written it down what the Lord spoke to me today. I believe the tsunami wave of revival, the greatest move of God of all time, is breaking upon us globally. Despite the corona viral horrors, it is bringing us from the retreat, Christians in retreat, to Christians in advancement. The prophets and the sons of prophets are giving a wake-up call to our generation all over the world in preparing the bride for the soon coming return of the heavenly bridegroom, our Lord Jesus Christ. For the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. For all over the world the Spirit is moving, as the waters cover the sea. Right here in our midst the Spirit is moving, and the prophets are rising up all over the world to be able to speak that prophetic word, to be a prophetic voice in the church, to be a prophetic voice in the world, and to be a prophetic voice to the governments of the world. And the Lord is raising these people on the last day. Hallelujah. And a heavenly bridegroom will soon come to claim his bride and take her home to dwell with him on high. Trim your lamps. I said, trim your lamps. I said, trim your lamps and be ready, for the bridegroom draws nigh. The bridegroom comes, let no man doubt. Alas for those whose lamps are out, they'll find no oil to buy. I'm speaking to you a poem which I learned. And say it once again. The bridegroom comes, let no man doubt. Alas for those whose lamps are out, they'll find no oil to buy. Who ready are shall enter in, the marriage feast will then begin. And every tear be dry. The righteous saved forevermore, their God shall ceaselessly adore, in bliss beyond the sky. O sinner, ere it be too late, flee now to mercy's open gate, and join Christ's waiting band. These are echoes of grace hymn book. And I want to tell you, beloved, this is the day which the Lord has made. We will rejoice and we will be glad in it. For these are the days that miracles are being performed. And I want to give you a word right now. There is going to come a time in our days where it's going to be phone miracles. These are the two words God gave me, phone miracles. And you shall lift up your phone, and when you pray for others, people will be healed on that phone connect between you and the other person. And whatever needs people have at this time, in that phone connection, there will be miracles performed, because it is not you, but the Spirit of God, the Greater One inside of you, that will give words in your mouth. For He has ordained you for a time like this. So you will rise up, arise, shine forth, for your light has come, and the glory of Yahweh rises upon you. Be blessed and highly favored. Hallelujah. Jesus is alive. Amen and amen. Happy Resurrection Day.